Good morning, students. In the today's class, we are going to see half-wave rectifier analysis part. Please tell me whether my screen is visible or not. Is it visible, students? Is it visible, Bargo?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay. This is the half-wave rectifier circuit diagram. AC input signal is provided by AC input signal is, let it be, this is the 230 volts AC input signal with sinusoidal type of input signal is provided with the positive half cycle and negative half cycle. This is the left side part. This is the left side part consists of more number of turns on the primary side and less number of turns on secondary side. It is the, we can call this left side as primary winding side. In the right side part, I can call this winding as secondary winding. This is the step down transformer. I am using step down transformer. Let us, we will go for construction part. What is the basic principle? The basic principle of rectifier is converting AC signal to pulsating DC signal. This is the basic principle. It converts the AC signal, it converts the AC input signal into pulsating DC output signal. This is the basic principle. For every rectifier, you are supposed to write this word over there. You are supposed to write the basic principle in every rectifier. That is, it may be a half-wave rectifier, full-wave rectifier, or bridge rectifier. And we will see the construction part of half-wave rectifier. In that, first one is the transformer. This is the step-down transformer I am using here, and one diode and load resistance is applied in order to make this as a closed circuit here. And this is the construction part. Across the load resistance part, I am going to acquire the output voltage here. Output voltage is going to be obtained from the load resistance RL. This is the, by applying this transformer, the flow of current will take place inside this circuit. The flow of current will take place in this direction. In this direction, across this RL, I am going to acquire the output voltage. This is the output voltage V naught. This is the input voltage V in. Let it be. This is the input voltage V in. And this is the output voltage V naught. With respect to the time, with respect to frequency, I am taking it as omega t. Omega t. This is 0 to pi, and pi to 2 pi. Like that, I am going to consider the angular frequency. I am going to consider here, that's why it is indicated with omega here. And here the flow of current is I. The flow of current is I, diode D, and load resistance RL. Here the transformer, that is step down transformer. Why? Because less number of turns on secondary side. Less number of turns on secondary side, therefore it is a step down transformer. This is the positive half cycle. And this is the negative half cycle. This is the circuit diagram construction. First one is step down transformer. Second one is diode. Third one is load resistance. First one is this one. Transformer I am using. Second one is diode. And third one is load resistance RL. Load resistance RL. By considering these three, we will conclude that this is the construction part of the half-wave rectifier. And thereafter, we will see the analysis part of half-wave rectifier. Before going to the analysis part, what is the operation of half-wave rectifier? We are supposed to do the operation of the half-wave rectifier. That means, I am applying some AC type of input signal. This AC type of input signal is transmitted and the flow of current takes place inside the circuit. Due to the flow of current, this diode acts as a closed switch. Let it be, this is the closed switch. Why? Because the flow of current is in the same direction with respect to the diode, and this diode is in the just like a forward bias condition. Therefore, I can call this diode is in on condition here. This is in the on position state of diode. It is going to be on. This is the on position state of diode. Thereafter, for negative half cycle is applied to the diode. That means negative voltage. Let it be. This is the maximum voltage and this is the minimum voltage. That is maximum voltage is Vm, and minimum voltage is reverse voltage is minus Vm. Like that, this is the maximum voltage Vm with respect to the positive half cycle. Negative half cycle minus Vm is the maximum voltage. And this reverse voltage is applied to the diode. That means negative positive terminal of the positive. This is the anode terminal is connected to negative, and the cathode terminal is connected to positive. That means this diode is in reverse bias condition. Therefore, this acts as open switch here. It acts as open switch in the reverse bias condition. Open switch or open circuit. Then I can call this diode is in off position here. It is going to be off. This is the position of off condition. That means 0 to pi diode is on. 0 to pi cycle for the first positive half cycle diode is on. For pi to 2 pi diode is off. Why? Because it is in reverse bias position. Therefore, this diode is in off position here. This is the on position and this is the off position. We are in the analysis part, we are going to consider these two ranges here. That is 0 to pi is considered, as well as pi to 2 pi, two ranges I am going to consider in the analysis part. Ante oka positive, idi oka cycle amma. This is the cycle. Let it be, this is the time period. From this time period, we can acquire the frequency part. That t is equal to 1 by f. These two components are inversely proportional to each other. That means t is equal to 1 by f. I can acquire the time period with respect to this frequency component also. Like that, we are going to calculate this frequency component. By obtaining this frequency component, I can calculate this time period. If I am acquiring this time period, I can calculate this frequency also. Like that, I am going to calculate further in the practical sessions. We will calculate the time period as well as frequency component like this. This is about the construction part as well as the operation part of the half wave rectifier. Thereafter, we will see this analysis part. This is the principle. Basic principle is converting AC voltage into pulsating DC voltage. This is the construction part. That is transformer. It consists of transformer, diode, and one load resistance. And operation part is for positive half cycle, the diode is going to be on. For negative half cycle, the diode going to be off. Conduction will take place from 0 to pi, and non-conducting state is pi to 2 pi. Next, we will see this is the positive half cycle, negative half cycle, and the rectifier output voltage will be in phase. That is, the starting and ending points are same phase for both the waveforms. That is 0 to pi conducting. 0 to pi, let it be, I will go with this diagram. 0 to pi, this diode is in on state. Pi to 2 pi, this diode is in off state. Like that, this diode is on from 0 to pi. Off state, this diode is in off state, pi to 2 pi. I am taking the same same value from this notation 0 to pi. This input and output waveforms are in phase with respect to the AC input signal. Then analysis of half wave rectifier, please note it down from here onwards. Input sinusoidal voltage applied at the input of the transformer is given by the applied voltage VI is given by Vm sin omega t. Please note down this one, VI, that input voltage VI is equal to Vm sin omega t, where Vm is the maximum voltage, sin omega t, sinusoidal voltage, sinusoidal type of signal is applied here, therefore sin omega t. Input voltage is given by, this input voltage is given by VI, this input voltage VI is equal to Vm sin omega t. Vm sin omega t. This is the first equation you are supposed to write. Right. Next one. The diode current or the load current is given by I of t. Similarly, input voltage grasamma. I equation input voltage grasnatle. You put with respect to current grasthon. Same other equation with respect to current. ఇక్కడ ఇదే వేఫాము మనం ఇక్కడ ఏంటి మనం వోల్టేజ్కి చెప్తున్నాం కరెంట్కి చెప్తున్నాం అంటే రెండు టర్మ్స్ కూడా రాయొచ్చు అని చెప్పి చెప్తున్నట్టు అనమాట ఇప్పుడు దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఇన్పుట్ వేఫామ్ అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ ది అవుట్పుట్ వేఫామ్ అట్లాగా ఇక్కడ కరెంట్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు కరెంట్ కూడా చెప్తున్నాం అనమాట ద డయోడ్ కరెంట్ ఆర్ ది లోడ్ కరెంట్ కొన్ని టెక్స్ట్ బుక్లు ఏంటంటే విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు వోల్టేజ్ డెరివేషన్ పార్ట్ చేస్తారు కొంతమంది ఏంటంటే కరెంట్తో డెరివేషన్ పార్ట్ చేయొచ్చు అనమాట అట్లా అందుకోసం హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బై ఐ ఆఫ్ టీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు Im sin omega t. Im is the maximum current value and sin omega t is the applied to the sinusoidal type of signal, that is sin omega t. For 0 to pi, that range is the diode range, conducting state range is 0 to pi, that is given here. Is given by 0 less than omega t less than pi for positive half cycle. It is for positive half cycle. Similarly, I of t is equal to 0 for pi less than omega t less than 2 pi for negative half cycle. That means I of t or V of t with respect to positive half cycle is 0 to pi. This omega t is in the range 0 less than omega t less than pi. And that is positive half cycle, and negative half cycle is pi less than omega t less than 2 pi. That is the negative half cycle. That is the point given here. This is the first one is for positive half cycle, and second one is for negative half cycle. The maximum or peak current through the circuit. Is given by maximum voltage. What is the maximum voltage? We know the basic version that is V is equal to IR. This is the V is equal to IR. From that, what is the maximum voltage is Vm, and what is the maximum current I will acquire by that. Like that, this R can be given as it is a combination of some load resistance as well as forward diode possesses some resistance is there. That diode resistance is considered, that is RF, as well as in that circuit and load resistance is also considered, that is RL, RF plus RL. ఇక్కడ కొన్నిసార్లు ఏంటంటే RL plus RF అని కూడా రాస్తాం అన్నమాట. అట్లయినా రాసుకోవచ్చు. ఇట్ ఈస్ డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ యువర్ view, point of view. That means you can represent any type here, but for our convenience we written like this. Vm, that maximum voltage Vm is equal to Im R. R can be given as RF plus RL, that is equal to, and I will substitute this Im, that implies Im is equal to Vm by RF plus RL, where RF is forward resistance of diode, RL is load resistance of diode. Is it okay? Are you writing this one? Till this point you have written. Ikkada rasaru amma, please anyone yes, respond. Okay, right. Shall I move on to the next page? Okay, I am moving on to the next page. Up to this point, we can calculate Vm as well as Im. Thereafter, first parameter is average or DC current. Average or DC current, we can write it as IDC, I suffix DC, or I average, I suffix AVG. AVG. We can write it as average value or DC value. దీనికి టూ నేమ్స్ ఉంటాయి అన్నమాట, యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ అంటాం లేకపోతే డిసి వాల్యూ అంటాం అనమాట. అదే రాస్తున్నాం అనమాట. దట్ మీన్స్ యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ ఈజ్ గివెన్ బై ఏరియా అండర్ ది కర్వ్ బై పీరియడ్. ఏరియా అండర్ ది కర్వ్ బై పీరియడ్ దట్ మీన్స్ టి, ఇట్ ఈస్ టి అండ్ ద ఏరియా అండర్ ది కర్వ్. దిస్ ఈస్ ది యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ. యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ, దిస్ ఈస్ ద నార్మల్ నొటేషన్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ ఏరియా అండర్ ది కర్వ్. జస్ట్ స్టూడెంట్స్, ఎంఐ ఆడిబుల్ స్టూడెంట్స్?
Yes, sir.
ఓకే ఓకే, నాది ఇప్పుడే పవర్ ఆఫ్ అయిందమ్మా. ఇప్పుడు ఆడిబులే కదా, ఒకసారి మళ్ళీ స్క్రీన్ షేర్ చేస్తున్నాను చూడండి. ఈజ్ ఇట్ విజిబుల్?
Yes, sir.
ఓకే, రైట్ హియర్ హియర్ దిస్ ఈస్ ది average value or DC value. The meaning for average value is area under the curve by period, time period. And we will going to notate IDC or I average is given by 1 by T, this time period, this is 1 by T integral. That area under the curve can be given by integral 0 to T I of T dt. We know this one, I of T. What is I of T here? What is I of T? I of T is equal to Im sin omega. I am going to substitute this I of t in that equation. In that equation, I am going to substitute here. I of t is Im sin omega t. T is can be given with respect to omega t. That means Im sin omega t d of omega t is substituted here. The time period is from the time period, the entire time period. I am taking entire time period, that is 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2 pi. I am considering, therefore that is 1 by 2 pi integral, time period is 0 to 2 pi Im sin omega t d of omega t. That is the meaning of this equation IDC or I average 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi Im sin omega t d of omega t. As no current flows through the negative half cycle of AC input voltage, that is between omega t is equal to pi to 2 pi. Pi to 2 pi. ఇక్కడ ఈ పై టు టూ పైకి మనం డివైడ్ చేస్తాం, ఈ రేంజ్ని డివైడ్ చేస్తున్నాం. ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు డివైడ్ ద రేంజ్ హియర్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు డివైడ్ ద రేంజ్ దట్ ఈస్ 0 to pi వన్ రేంజ్ అండ్ పై టు టూ పై అనదర్ రేంజ్. దట్ మీన్స్ 0 to pi, అగైన్ రైటింగ్ ద సేమ్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఐఎమ్ సైన్ ఒమేగా టి డి ఆఫ్ ఒమేగా టి ప్లస్ ఇంటిగ్రల్ పై టు టూ పై ఐఎమ్ సైన్ ఒమేగా టి డి ఆఫ్ ఒమేగా టి. ఈ స్ప్లిట్ చేసాం. ఈ స్ప్లిట్ చేసిన తర్వాత దిస్ పార్ట్ ఐఎమ్ కన్సిడరింగ్ దిస్ పార్ట్, దిస్ ఈస్ ది నాన్ కండక్టింగ్ పార్ట్ పై టు టూ పై. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు కండక్ట్, ద ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ కరెంట్ ఈస్ జీరో. దెన్ దిస్ టర్మ్ విల్ బికమ్ జీరో అండ్ ఐ విల్ ఎలిమినేట్ దిస్ టర్మ్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ఎలిమినేట్ దిస్ టర్మ్. దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు కన్సిడర్ ఓన్లీ దిస్ టర్మ్. ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు కన్సిడర్ this term, therefore I can write it as 1 by 2 pi common term 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi Im sin omega t d of omega t. Thereafter I will take out this constant term. I will take out this constant term Im outside of this term. Therefore Im by 2 pi integral 0 to pi sin omega t d of omega t. Integral sin omega t. Integral sin omega t is given by minus cos omega t. We know this formula. Therefore, integral sin omega t is equal to minus cos omega t. Then this this range 0 to pi is the range. That range is provided here, that is 0 to pi. And by substituting this 0 value as well as pi value in this minus cos omega t, I will get some values here. Therefore, Im by 2 pi, and take out this negative sign outside. Thereafter, apply this range here. Apply this range. Therefore, that range is cos pi minus cos 0. Cos pi value is minus 1. Cos 0 value is 1. Cos 0 value is 1. This value is minus 1. And this value is also minus 1. Therefore, I will substitute this value, these two values. Thereafter, minus Im by 2 pi into minus 2. This minus and minus get cancels. This 2 and this 2 get cancels here. Therefore, finally, I can acquire Im by pi. This is the final term for I average or IDC value. Basic formula is by substituting this formula, that is IDC or I average value, that is given by 1 by t integral 0 to t I of t dt. I of t is given by Im sin omega t. By substituting these terms, thereafter by integrating these terms, I can get the integral of sin omega t is minus cos omega t by substituting only this range. That means 0 to pi is conducting state. The conducting state is only, that is with respect to the positive half cycle, conducting state is 0 to pi only. And this is the not conducting state. To pi to 2 pi is not conducting state. That is half position of the diode. Therefore, I am taking only this range. I am substituting the values here. Integral of sin omega t is given by minus cos omega t. Thereafter, by substituting these two range values here, I can acquire IDC or I average value as Im by pi. Is it finished, amma? Ikkada finish ayinda meedi? Is it finished? Ikkada work ayinda?
Yes, sir.
Chesara, amma? Chesukuntunnara? పారలల్గా చేయండి ప్లీజ్, ఎందుకంటే చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఎక్స్టర్నల్కి ఇంటర్నల్కి చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్. మీరు ప్యారలల్గా చేస్తేనే మీకు అర్థమైంది. ఒకసారి ప్రాక్టీస్ కూడా అయితే. అండ్ దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఐ కెన్ నో ది వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది డిసి వాల్యూ ఆర్ యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ హాఫ్ వేవ్ రెక్టిఫైయర్. దిస్ ఈస్ ది ఫస్ట్ టర్మ్. అండ్ బై దిస్ ఈస్ ది జస్ట్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ పార్ట్. దిస్ ఈస్ జస్ట్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ పార్ట్, దట్ ఈస్ ఐడిసి. ఇక్కడ వరకు మెయిన్ అమ్మ, ఇక్కడ వరకే మెయిన్, ఇది వచ్చిన తర్వాత. అండ్ ఐడిసి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఐఎం బై పై, దట్ ఈస్ ఐ యావరేజ్ వాల్యూ. అగైన్ ఐడిసి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు వీ నో ది వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ వాల్యూ. ఐడిసి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఐ వాల్యూ. ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ దిస్ ఐ వాల్యూ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ విఎం వాల్యూ ఇన్ దట్ ఈక్వేషన్. ఆ ఈక్వేషన్లో నేను సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తాను అన్నమాట. దేర్ ఫోర్ ఐడిసి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు విఎం బై పై ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎఫ్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ఎల్. అంటే కరెంట్ ఈక్వేషన్ని ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ వోల్టేజ్ అండ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్లో రాస్తున్నాం అనమాట. అదే ఐడిసి వాల్యూని ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ వోల్టేజ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్లో రాస్తున్నాం. దట్ ఈజ్ ఐడిసి వాల్యూ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు విఎం బై పై ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎఫ్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ఎల్. దిస్ ఇస్ ది వాల్యూ ఆర్ఎఫ్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ఎల్. This is the value in terms of voltage and resistance, and this is the value in terms of only current, that is IDC or I average value Im by pi. This is with respect to voltage and resistance. For the sake of solving some different type of problems, we are supposed to derive this term as well as this term. Similarly, the DC output voltage or average voltage is given by VDC is equal to IDC into RL. VDC is given by IDC into RL. Since we know this V is equal to IR, from this basic formula, we are substituting in suffix notation enti ikkada suffix notation dc ani vastam anamata that is vdc is equal to idc I ki suffix lo dc into rl therefore idc value we know this idc value and I can substitute here I can substitute that idc value here therefore vdc is equal to vm by pi into rf plus rl into rl and I will take this value in the denominator side like this therefore vm by pi into rf plus rl by rl and I can make this simplification further simplifying of this term then vm by pi into 1 plus this is 1 rf plus rl and rl will become 1 plus rf by rl that implies vdc is equal to vm by pi into 1 plus rf by rl 1 plus rf by rl if this term is very much less than 1 if this term is very much less than 1 then vdc is given by vm by pi ee term chaala small value anukundamma ee term small value aithe automatically the final term will become vdc is equal to vm by pi this is the term we have idc value as well as vdc value just substituting whatever the terms we have possessed previously okay this is the term I average basic term is this one by taking this term what are the notation for I of t is im sin omega t after substituting im sin omega t and the range value is split here and I am not going to consider this second range value that is pi to 2 pi why because diode is not conducted for this range therefore I will consider only conducting range that is 0 to pi and I will equate idc value as im by pi similarly with respect to the voltage and resistance values that idc value is given by vm by pi into rf plus rl by substituting v is equal to ir formula like that we can calculate vdc value also that vdc value is given by vm by pi therefore I can conclude that this dc value or I average value is given by with respect to the current is vm by pi with respect to voltage is vm by pi im by ikkademo I antamma with respect to current aithe im by pi with respect to voltage aithe vm by pi that is the notation for dc value or average value here and next one is rms value of load current rms value of load current this term is also very important these two terms ee first manam derive chese ee dc value average value ee rms value ve baaga important anamata this is the rms value normal notation rms value is given by square root of area under the squared input by period this is the normal representation that is rms value is given by area under the squared input wave by period and I will consider this is the basic term rms value term is given by square root of period 1 by t integral 0 to t square of squared input waveform that is integral 0 to t I square of t input waveform is I square of t dt what is i of t term then im sin omega t is going to be substituted here that is im square it is squaring here therefore im square sin square omega t d of omega t and time period is 0 to 2 pi therefore 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi im square sin square omega t d of omega t that is equal to integral I am splitting this range here square root of 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi im square sin square omega t d of omega t plus integral pi to 2 pi im square sine square omega t d of omega t. This range, this is the non-conducting range, therefore I am not going to take this term. I am not going to take this term, and I will leave this term, and I will leave the I will only go with this term. This is the conducting state and this is the non-conducting state. Thereafter, square root of 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi Im square sine square omega t d of omega t. And by taking this common term outside, therefore square root of Im square by 2 pi integral 0 to pi, this sine square omega t can be represented as 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Cos 2 omega t by 2. It is represented as sine square omega t ni manam itla raskochuga. Itla rastam anamata. 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 d of omega t. Thereafter, this common term Im square by 2 pi. This is the by substituting this value here, and that is omega t by 2 minus integral on integration of this cos 2 omega t, then it will become sine 2 omega t by 4. Thereafter I will apply this range here. I am going to apply the range for this term. Thereafter I am going to consider this common term here as well as this term 0 to pi pi by 2 by substituting this value here sine 2 pi. What is the value of sine 2 pi? Tell me sine 2 pi value, please tell me. Chapali evaraina parled meeru chestunnattu naaku ardham ayyadu atla chepte. Anyone please respond.
Anyone? Zero, sir.
Okay, zero. By substituting that zero value here, I can eliminate this term. I am going to eliminate this term. I can substitute only omega t by 2. Therefore, that value is pi by 2 here. Then Im square by 2 pi into pi by 2. Pi and pi, this get cancels here. Square root of Im square by 4, that is equal to Im by 2. Finally, IRMS value is this one. IRMS value is given by IRMS is equal to Im by 2 is the final term. Final term I am going to acquire here. Just I am taking square of this input signal, that is I square of t, by substituting Im sine omega t here, then the term will become Im square sine square omega t, and splitting these two ranges, splitting the range here, that is 0 to pi, pi to 2 pi, and only considering conducting range, that range is this one, and by substituting the sine square omega t value in terms of cos 2 omega t, 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 with respect to this sine square omega t term, but after substituting this value, range is this by applying the integral part with respect to this constant term, that means it will become omega t by 2, and integral of this cos 2 omega t will become sine 2 omega 2 by 4, and by substituting this pi in this sine 2 omega t position, then it will become 2 pi value is 0, then this term is going to be cancels out. Therefore, final term I am going to acquire is Im square by 4, that is equal to square root is there, therefore this square as well as this root get cancels, and Im by 2. Final term is Im by 2 is acquired here. That is, that value is IRMS is equal to Im by 2. Ikkada chesaramma? Is it finished till now? Please anyone respond. Is it finished, sir. Till now? Okay, right. Next one. Further. IRMS is equal to Im by 2. Further, we know that Im is equal to Vm by Rf plus RL. Similarly, RMS voltage, we are supposed to calculate RMS voltage also here. Let it be here. ఈ ఐఎం వాల్యూ ఇది మనకు బేసిక్ గా తెలుసు అమ్మా, ఫస్ట్ లో తీసుకున్నాం కాబట్టి ఈ ఈక్వేషన్ మళ్ళీ ఇక్కడ రాసుకున్నాం. అండ్ సిమిలర్లీ ఆర్ఎంఎస్ వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ లోడ్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బై విఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎల్, ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎల్ వేర్ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఈస్, వేర్ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఈస్ దట్ ఈస్ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ వాల్యూ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ హియర్ దట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బై దిస్ వాల్యూ, దిస్ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ వాల్యూ we know this value that is im by 2. Similarly this irms value is going to be vm by actually this should be converted with respect to voltage also. Irms value ni in terms of voltage lo convert chesthe, in terms of voltage lo convert chesthe idu ochindi kada amma, ikkada actually ga ikkada implies petti irms is equal to vm by 2 into rf plus rl nu raaskovali ఫస్ట్ అట్లా రాసుకుంటే ఇది సరిపోయింది అనమాట. అప్పుడు సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేసుకోవాలి. అక్కడ ఇక్కడ రాయటం ఆ పర్టికులర్ స్టూడెంట్ రాయటం మర్చిపోయినట్టుంది. అక్కడ ఇది రాయాలమ్మా యాక్చువల్గా ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు విఎం బై 2 ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎఫ్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ఎల్. అది రాసుకున్న తర్వాత దీనికి ఇంప్లైస్ పెట్టుకొని అట్లా రాసుకోండి. ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు విఎం బై 2 ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎఫ్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ఎల్ ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎల్. దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ విఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు బై సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ దట్ వాల్యూ హియర్ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎల్ బై సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ దోస్ వాల్యూస్ హియర్ లైక్ దిస్ అండ్ విఎం బై 2 ఇంటూ ఐ విల్ టేక్ దిస్ అగైన్ ఐ విల్ టేక్ దిస్ టర్మ్ ఇన్ ద న్యూమరేటర్ సైడ్ ఇన్ ద డినామినేటర్ సైడ్ సారీ ఇన్ ద డినామినేటర్ సైడ్ దెన్ దిస్ టర్మ్ విల్ బికమ్ విఎం బై 2 ఇంటూ ఆర్ఎఫ్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ఎల్ బై ఆర్ఎల్ దెన్ దిస్ టర్మ్ విల్ బికమ్ వన్ విఆర్ఎంఎస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు విఎం బై 2 into 1 plus RF by RL. 1 plus RF by RL is the term. If RF by RL term is very much less than 1, then VRMS is equal to VM by 2. VM by 2. This is the final term with respect to voltage. That means with respect to current, it is IM by 2. With respect to voltage, that is VM by 2 for RMS values here. We can calculate both voltage term as well as current term that is root mean square squared input is provided with respect to this time period t. Root mean square value is calculated here. This is the basic term. IRMS is equal to square root of 1 by t integral 0 to t I square of t dt. By substituting the basic I of t term in this equation, by simplifying the trigonometric terms as well as by applying these trigonometric terms with respect to the integration of this trigonometric term, I can acquire the IRMS value, that is IM by 2. With respect to the voltage, by substituting this basic IN term in terms of IRMS, I can calculate what is the VRMS term also. I can obtain this VRMS term, that is VM by 2. Thereafter, this is the DC output power and AC input power. We are supposed to calculate. Why we are calculating this DC output power and AC input power means, in order to calculate efficiency is given by simply output by input. That means this output may be in terms of voltage, current, power also. I can acquire voltage, current and power. By combination of voltage and current, I can acquire power also. By this combination, I can acquire power. Efficiency means can be given as output by input. Here, what is the output? Anyone please respond? Anyone? What is the output here? What is the output in our circuit, in half wave rectifier? What is the output?
DC
pulsating DC output voltage. Antega pulsating DC output voltage. This is the output is pulsating DC output voltage, that is V naught అనుకుంటాం. Input to input AC input. AC input ఏగా AC input. For that sake, in order to obtain the DC output and AC input, I am going to obtain two power levels with respect to the in order to calculate the efficiency in terms of power calculate cheyadam kosam I am going DC output power and AC input power, ee two terms ni calculate cheyadam kosam in order to derive that efficiency term I am supposed to go with DC output power and AC input power. ఈ ఏసీ ఇన్పుట్ పవర్ డిసి అవుట్పుట్ పవర్ని క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ఎందుకు చేస్తున్నావు అంటే ముందు ఎందుకు చేసి పెట్టుకుంటున్నావు అంటే ఈ ఎఫిషియన్సీని క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసుకోవడం కోసం. ఓకే, దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద డిసి అవుట్పుట్ పవర్ డెవలప్డ్ అక్రాస్ లోడ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్. అవుట్పుట్ సైడ్ ఏంటి, ఈ లోడ్ రెసిస్టెన్సేగా, ఇది అవుట్పుట్ సైడ్ సర్క్యూట్ డయాగ్రామ్, లోడ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ అవుట్పుట్ సైడ్, ఇదేగా లోడ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ సైడ్ ఇస్ ది అవుట్పుట్ సైడ్, దిస్ ఇస్ ది load resistance side. The DC output power developed across load resistance RL is given by PDC, P suffix DC means power, DC power amma ide. P suffix DC means DC power, that is equal to, we know the basic formula with respect to the in terms of P is equal to VI where V can be given as IR, therefore I can write it as I square R here. Power can be in terms of only current and resistance, therefore I square R. This is the basic formula for power. In terms of the DC value, I am taking the DC value here, VDC is equal to IDC square suffix DC, IDC square into with respect to the output side కాబట్టి load resistance, I am considering load resistance here, that resistance is RL, therefore PDC is equal to IDC square into RL. That means what is IDC value, tell me, IDC or I average value ఎంత వచ్చిందమ్మా మనకి ప్రీవియస్ గా,
Im by pi.
I am substituting that Im by pi here, therefore PDC is equal to Im square by pi square into RL. I am substituting that IDC value here, Im square by pi square into RL. After substituting that, I will calculate, this is the DC power, output power calculate chesanu anamata ippudu, ante ee term ni calculate chesukunna, ee numerator lo unna term ni calculate chesukunnanu anamata. Next, total AC power is given by PD plus PL, this is the power dissipation across diode. PD means power dissipation across diode, power dissipation across load resistance. PL is the power dissipation across diode daggara power dissipation enta jarugutundi and load resistance daggara power dissipation enta jarugutundo calculate chestunnam anamata, and that power dissipation across diode is given by that this is the across diode, I am supposed to calculate AC term, I can tell this as RMS value here. AC term entante RMS value ga anukuntam anamata, I RMS square into RF, that forward resistance is present in diode, that is I RMS square into RF, that is given by RMS value. What is the RMS value we have calculated previously?
Im by 2.
This is the Im by 2 value I am substituting here again. That is Im square by 4 into RF. I am substituting PD value here. PD is equal to I RMS square into RF. That is equal to Im square by 4 into RF. Thereafter, with respect to the AC type of signal only, therefore I am considering only RMS square into, ఇదేంటి, ఇది ఫార్వర్డ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, ఇది డయోడ్ దగ్గర, అక్రాస్ డయోడ్ దగ్గర కాబట్టి ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ద రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఇన్ ది డయోడ్, దట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఈస్ ఫార్వర్డ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ఆర్ఎఫ్. RF. With respect to the load resistance, unknown. Same adhe IRMS term. With respect to this resistance is RLV will become. It is going to be across load resistance part. This power is going to be power dissipation is across load resistance. Therefore, I can substitute IRMS square into RL. Therefore, I can substitute IM square by 4 into RL. Finally, PAC is equal to substituting this term as well as this term here. IM square by 4 into RF plus IM square by 4 into RL. And finally, we can write it as PA is equal to IM square by 4 into RF plus RL. This is the term for PAC. PAC. This is the term for PAC. This is the term for PDC value. By substituting these two values, PAC value and PDC value, I can acquire efficiency. We are going to derive that efficiency part here. This is the rectifier efficiency. Rectifier efficiency is defined as ratio of DC output power to AC input power. Ippudu manam chesindi enti DC output power AC input power ga ippudu ee two terms derive chesukundi aa two terms e ippudu akkada substitute chestam anamata andukani idi first manam idi derivation part chesukoni pettukunam anamata and this is the efficiency eta is equal to this may be with respect to voltage or current or power. This is with respect to power. With respect to power that is given by output power by input power. That output power is in terms of DC. That input power is in terms of AC. AC. Therefore, I am going to substitute this this DC value, PDC value there and PAC value there. Here PDC is equal to IM square by pi square into RL by IM square by 4 into RF plus RL. That is equal to I am just rearranging the terms here. This 4 is going to be obtained in numerator side. Therefore, 4 by pi square, this IM square and IM square get cancels. Therefore, it will become 4 by pi square into RL by RF plus RL. And take this RL term in the denominator side. Then it will become. Just calculate 4 by pi square. 4 by pi square ni calculate cheyandam okkasari. Mee daggara calculator unte. Ee rectifiers lo mee daggara calculator kuda pettukondi pakkana better. 4 by pi square. Enta vachindi value chudandi okkasari. Okkasari choose cheppali. 4 by pi square value enta vachindi?
0.40.
Next term. 5. 9 5 2 వచ్చిందా ఓకే ఓకే జస్ట్ ఐ యామ్ మేకింగ్ ద టర్మ్ ఎంటైర్ టర్మ్ ను ఒక 0.406 అనుకుంటున్నా ఆ టర్మ్ ను మొత్తం తీసేసి ఓకేనా దట్ ఇస్ 0.406 అండ్ బై సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ దిస్ ఆర్ఎల్ వాల్యూ అండ్ ఆర్ఎఫ్ వాల్యూ ఇన్ ద డినామినేటర్ సైడ్ దెన్ ఇట్ విల్ బికమ్ 0.406 ఇంటూ 1 plus RF by RL. RF by RL. This is the final term. Ippudu for example, into 100 is anamma. Into 100 is the. Then I can calculate this efficiency in terms of percentages. Into 100 is the, it will become. It is converted into percentages here. That is given as. Ippudu 100 multiply is the anta utundi 40.6 by 1 plus RF by RL. 1 plus RF by RL is the term I am going to acquire here. Therefore, rectifier efficiency increases if ratio RF by RL is negligible. If this term, this RF by RL term is negligible. Ante, if the term is very small. ఈ ఆర్ఎఫ్ అంటే ఇంటర్నల్లీ ప్రెజెంట్ దిస్ ఫార్వర్డ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ ది డయోడ్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ లోడ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ ది సర్క్యూట్ ఈజ్ వెరీ లో అనుకుందాం వెరీ లో వాల్యూ వచ్చింది అనుకుందాం దెన్ ఐ కెన్ అక్వైర్డ్ లార్జ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎఫిషియన్సీ హియర్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు అక్వైర్ లార్జ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎఫిషియన్సీ దట్ ఈస్ రెక్టిఫైయర్ ఎఫిషియన్సీ కెన్ బి ఇంక్రీస్డ్ ఇఫ్ ద రేషియో ఆర్ఎఫ్ బై ఆర్ఎల్ ఈజ్ నెగ్లిజిబుల్ ఆర్ స్మాల్ వాల్యూ Therefore, the maximum theoretical value of rectifier efficiency of a half wave rectifier is 40.6%. 40.6% is the value you are supposed to memorize. Finally, I can conclude that the efficiency of this half wave rectifier is 40.6. From this we can acquire, this is the DC output power and AC input power. By substituting this DC power and AC power in this equation, I can acquire the percentage efficiency. Percentage efficiency I can acquire. Just a minute. Next value, these two terms only, there is no derivation part, only just defining parts are there. Only defining set. Peak inverse voltage, this is the maximum voltage with which rectifier has to withstand during non-conducting period or reverse biasing state. Reverse biasing state lo, non-conducting state lo, diode withstand avalanamata. Aa diode withstand ayye voltage ni peak inverse voltage antamma. Peak inverse voltage, it is the maximum voltage with which rectifier has to withstand during non-conducting state or reverse biasing state. Non-conducting state or reverse biasing state, that reverse biasing state maximum voltage is Vm. Maximum voltage is Vm. That voltage is given by peak inverse voltage is here. In a half wave rectifier, peak inverse voltage equals the peak value of the applied voltage, that is given by PIV is equal to Vm. Under reverse bias condition, maximum voltage is Vm, that is provided here. Maximum voltage is Vm. In the non-conducting state or in the reverse biasing condition, maximum voltage is Vm. Therefore, peak inverse voltage is given by PIV is equal to Vm. Vm. This is the term you are supposed to memorize. Thereafter, form factor. Form factor is given by RMS value by average value here. Form factor is given by RMS value by average value. Form factor is equal to, I am notating just a short form, FF means form factor, is equal to RMS value by average value. RMS value is, we know this IRMS value, that is Im by 2. I average value, I know this term, I average value also, Im by pi. By substituting these two terms, then I can acquire pi by 2 value. Pi by 2 value is equal to, just calculate this pi by 2 value and see. Just verify pi by 2 value. What is the pi by 2 value? Tell me anyone. What is the value you are obtaining? 1.57 only? You are getting 1.57 only?
1.570, sir.
Right. That is the form factor value. This form factor is given by RMS value by average value. By substituting these two values here, I can acquire pi by 2. Therefore, finally, 1.57 is the form factor value. And peak factor value, it is the ratio of peak value to the RMS value. Peak value to the RMS value. Peak value by RMS value. That peak value is Vm by VRMS value. Here you can substitute either voltage or current. A substitute chesna parledu. Ante nenu oka term lo current substitute chesanu, inko term lo voltage substitute chesanu. Meer kavalante ikkada rendu current e substitute chesukochu. Appudu that will become Im by IRMS value avutundi. Appudu in terms of ikkada V lo rastunnam, ikkada current lo rastam ante. Then this term can be written here Im by IRMS. Then with respect to Im, that is will become Im, and IRMS Im by 2 get cancels, or Vm get cancels here. Therefore, I can acquire the term 2 here. Peak factor is given by 2. Like this, you can write in terms of current or voltage also. Therefore, this is about form factor, and this is about peak factor. And till now we have seen the peak inverse voltage, form factor, and peak factor. In the next class, we will see the ripple factor and transformer utilization factors also. we are going to derive those two terms also in the next class. Those two terms are also very important. Okay. ఇప్పుడు చేసిన ఈ ఫోర్ టర్మ్స్ మీరు డిరైవ్ చేసుకుని ఒకసారి మళ్ళీ చూసుకున్నాం. యావరేజ్ ఆర్ డిసి కరెంట్ వాల్యూ, ఆర్ఎంఎస్ వాల్యూ ఆర్ ఆర్ఎంఎస్ వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ లోడ్ కరెంట్, ఆర్ఎంఎస్ వాల్యూ దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ విఆర్ఎంఎస్, రెండు డిరైవ్ చేయాలి. అట్లనే ఇక్కడ VDC ఆర్ VDC ఆర్ VDC IDC ఆర్ VDC రెండు డిరైవ్ చేయాలి. ఇక్కడ ఐఆర్ఎంఎస్ విఆర్ఎంఎస్, ఇక్కడ PDC PAC. ఆ టూ టర్మ్స్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత ఎఫిషియన్సీ అవుట్పుట్ బై ఇన్పుట్. అప్పుడు ఆ టూ టర్మ్స్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత ఎఫిషియన్సీ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసుకున్నాం. ఆ ఎఫిషియన్సీ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసుకున్న తర్వాత దట్ ఈస్ 40.6% ఎఫిషియన్సీ అని చెప్పి చెప్తాం అన్నమాట. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ పీక్ ఇన్వర్స్ వోల్టేజ్, దిస్ ఈస్ ది నాన్ కండక్టింగ్ విత్ స్టాండింగ్ క్యాపబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ది డయోడ్ ఇన్ ది రివర్స్ కండిషన్ స్టేట్ ఆర్ నాన్ కండక్టింగ్ స్టేట్. దట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బై PIV ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు VM అండ్ పీక్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ 2, ఫార్మ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ 1.57. these terms you are supposed to again derive these all these terms and see. Okay, and again conclude with this. Thank you.